Welcome to the show. My name is Geoffrey Kerosi, and today we have a special guest by the name Paul Odongo. Paul Odongo is a budget facilitator and advocate from Kakamega County. He deals with a number of issues in the health sector. So today we want to understand what is happening in the health sector in Kakamega County. So welcome to the show and listen.
I'm Paul Odongo from Kakamega County. And I'm a director for a CBO known as Network for Research and Governance, which is based in Maraba State, Kakamega County, Lurambi Sub-County. And I deal on the issue of service delivery and governance. I deal also with the issue of health, specifically prevention on HIV/AIDS in public primary school and secondaries. And we also do media advocacy. We do a lot of advocacy, and also we do issues on education, advocacy on education.
Okay, so Paul, you mentioned that you do a lot of work around health sector. What is the health sector like in Kakamega County? Is it doing well? Are people accessing medical care near their homes, or they struggle to get the services?
Okay, that's a good question, Mr. Kerosi. The health sector, part of it that is doing well is in part of infrastructure. The development of infrastructure facility where the governor has allocated $500 million for phase two in completion of referral hospital. But in terms of services, sometimes we find the issue of shortage of drugs in the hospital, basic drugs, which you are referred to go to the nearest chemist. And I can just also say I cannot criticize a lot because the governor has a program called Linda Mama Afya Kwa Mtoto, Marisha Afya Mtoto na Mama program, which has allocated $100 million. However, there's a bottleneck in terms of selection criteria, and all the beneficiary cannot get the funds 100%. Yes.
So is this Linda Mama program the same as maternal health care provided by the national level? If they are different, how different are they?
Yeah, it's almost similar, but now this one is a governor initiative where he wants to improve the life of the infant or the child who is born, and also take care of the mother who is delivering the hospital. But it's not the zero campaign initiative for the national, which was initiated by the first lady, Margaret Kenyatta.
So for the county, you have been working on issues of sensitizing school children about HIV/AIDS and for those kids, how they can be safe from contracting HIV/AIDS, and those who have contracted, how they can be able to lead a better life even without the disease. How has the program been going so far?
The program has been good. It has been initiative of Network for Research and Governance. We have been doing it on a voluntary basis, and we piloted 7 schools in Kakamega, Lurambi sub-county. The program actually was embraced by the head teachers, and we usually do awareness creation, because in our country, the information, actually what informs us is the report for NASCOP and the Ministry of Education, that youth between 15 years 24 have contributed to high prevalence rates. That's why we go to the school. We find there's a gap, because when the program for HIV were coming, they were only targeting community members and adults, but they forgot youth in schools. And also the issue of risky behavior, which makes youth to get HIV. Youth are so rampant because of that adolescence age. When you educate them earlier, since time, at least they may transition to colleges with good behavior and avoid the issue of infection. Mm-hmm. Yes.
So, which methods do you advocate these kids can use? Because we know that sex education is in some places not a good topic to discuss. Some people, actually even parents, don't discuss with their children about sex, especially for primary school children. So how do you go about it? What do you advocate for these kids to do to avoid risky behavior?
That's a good question. We don't have the best practices currently, but what we did is we developed a standard manual in Gulf Hotel in partnership partnership with Casco and other health stakeholders. A simplified manual, then we also stricted not to highlight so much on sensitive issue like sexual intercourse, but we usually based on the ABC mode. Mm-hmm. Mostly we stick on the abstinence. Mm-hmm. But if we touch on the issue of sex, again it becomes sensitive and you get excited or you may get out of the objective. Mm-hmm. But the reality is that we have had cases of teenage pregnancies, and even recently in the media it has been captured that in Kakamega County the people who get pregnant or being seduced, mm-hmm, mostly by teachers, mm-hmm, is among the count that teachers seduce people. That's the reality. Mm-hmm. It's not against work. Yeah.
So there is that point whereby we learn that most pupils, even in primary schools, a good number are engaging in unsafe sexual activities. Then why do you insist that they should be educated on abstaining and not using condoms? Don't you think you should also tell them, those who are already doing or having sex, also to use condoms, because it is the reality?
Yeah, it's the reality, but per the standard on the manual, mm-hmm, and the issue of sensitivity, mm-hmm, it's a sensitive topic that when we start, the youth will get excited or get shy. Mm-hmm. But mostly we focus on abstinence, the ABCD model, this abstinence, being faithful, or use of condom. We don't touch use of condom, mm-hmm, because I usually tell them that you are active at your age, you are productive, but you can channel that that positive energy to something that is resourceful. You can engage in sport, you can engage in other things, mm-hmm, but mostly we focus on the topic called risky behavior. Mm-hmm. We just tell them that if you engage in risky behavior like unprotected sex, you will die. Mm-hmm. There's a probability of getting HIV. That's the most common mode. So we tell them to avoid risky behavior, the issue of drugs and peer influence, which can cause them, can trigger the issue of HIV. Mm-hmm. Yes.
So right now, are those pupils responding well? And if they are responding, what are some of the interesting ideas which have been generated from your conversation with the kids? What do you think is most interesting you have heard from the kids?
Yeah, because we are piloting, mm-hmm, we are in a process, actually we are debating the questionnaires, we are doing a survey, and we want to do analysis on the perception of HIV awareness from those youths. Mm-hmm. Then from there we shall have a report that we shall share with the Casco, the Ministry of Health, and the County Department in Health, Kakamega County. Mm-hmm. That one will inform even for people who can support or partners with us, because we find that they are taking it serious. The concentration is high. We are creating health club, mostly focus on HIV prevention, and we have even a slogan like avoid stigma, HIV kills. So that is soon we shall have a good impact, because those kind of slogan, they keep on reminding them, mm-hmm, and we find that they reduce the issue of risky behavior. Mm-hmm. So from the report, and after some time we shall measure, because you cannot measure as you are starting, mm-hmm, but you can measure even in the middle of the year or the end of the year, mm-hmm, to gauge the progress.
Yes. And now finally, there is the county mandate for them. They have the money to provide services and even sensitization on issues of HIV/AIDS. What is the county doing? Do they have the resources, for example, to give civic education on HIV/AIDS? Or what are they doing in the county level?
That one I can clearly report confidently that the county has done nothing in terms of awareness creation for HIV/AIDS in school. And it has an allocation for 3 million. Actually, it's 3 million for 2018-2019. And we find that they need to come up with those kind of strategy or even funders. Because what we see, it is in the syllabus when you are doing a questionnaire analysis. The HIV topics has been covered in the syllabus. But the county has not taken any initiative of sensitizing issues pertaining HIV in schools. They are only focusing on treatment and care.